Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to teach you how to create this feedback form in Word. So I'm going to create this completely from a table. So if I just click at the top left here, go to Table Design, go to Borders, and click right down at View Grid Lines, you can see this is a complete table. The thing with this though, there are a few techniques that you need to learn in order to make this as quick and as simple as possible. So we'll go back to a new document. And the first thing I'm going to do is just going to hit my return key a few times, just so we've got a little bit of space at the top here. Then I'm going to go to Insert, Table, click on the drop down, and I'm just going to create one row and seven columns. Now there is method to my madness here, because I know that the first row is just one cell, but it's easier to merge cells than it is to divide them. So I'm just going to move a couple of these lines over, and we're going to have the first row will be the numbers, then will be the question, and then will be the answer columns. So whilst a few of those rows were just singular, or there were just four columns, it's easier to create this first and merge. Once I've got the question cell the size I want it, I'm just going to select these five cells, go to Layout, and go to Distribute Columns. This will distribute them equally, and then all I need to do is select this row, go to Height, and I'm going to make the height 1 centimeter to give us a little bit more room. And then I'm going to go over to these. This is where your text will be in each cell. So I'm going to go to Align to Center Left to make sure the text is all over to the left, which the majority of it will be. Some will be centered and some will be elsewhere, but I'll show you how to do that as we go. So once you're happy with this row, just click inside, go to Layout, and go to Insert below, and just keep clicking on that button until we fill the page. Okay, once it's gone over, press Command or Control Z to go back and keep going back until you've just got that one page. So from that, we're going to develop this table. So the first thing is, as you can see, we've got probably two rows merged together to create this one cell at the top with this information in. So I'm just going to select this text. This text here does actually tell you what you need to put in this section if you want to develop a feedback form. But we're going to also concentrate on the construction as well. So let's go back to our form. And we're going to have two rows all merged together. So select them, go to Layout, and go to Merge Cells. And then we're just going to click inside and we're going to copy all of that text. The second thing to do is to leave a space. So we're just going to merge all of these cells together. Go to Layout, Merge Cells. And then we start on our description and our questions. So we've got 9 questions. So in here, I'm just going to put in 1, press my down arrow, and continue down with all of the numbers. And then I'm going to select them all to center them. Go to Layout, Center, Align Text. And then in here, I need to put the questions. Obviously, you'll have your own individual questions. So then at the top, you can see we've got these very dissatisfied, dissatisfied, neutral, satisfied, and very satisfied. So I'm going to copy all of those. You just need to type them into the cells. And then I'm just going to paste them in. Now you can see this has got slightly smaller text than the other text. And that's just so that I can fit them all into these narrow columns. You can see this one isn't quite centered. So to make sure they're all centered, select them, go to Layout, and go to Center Text. Once you've done that, we're going to leave a space. So again, Layout, Merge. And then here we're going to merge these two cells because we want to put in the preferred communication. And then I'm going to put in these and show you how to do the boxes. So I'm just going to copy this across. There we go. And I'm just going to zoom in. And then I'm going to type in the various communications. And then for these, I'm going to reduce the size so that I can fit the boxes in. So go to Layout, go to Home, Reduce Text Size. There we go. And then go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down, select this square, and then just click. Go to Shape Format, go to Outline, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select Black. go to shape fill, click on the drop down and select no fill. And then I'm just going to reduce the size of this. Now this can be a little tricky on moving the size of these shapes around. So we've got 32 there, and then I'm just going to copy it, Command and Control C, deselect it, Command and Control V, deselect, Command and Control V, deselect, Command and Control V. I want 5 of these, deselect, there we go, that should be all 5. So let's just zoom in. So click and move them across. Don't worry too much at the moment about everything moving, because we will come back and sort that out. I think we've got an extra one here. So let's just select that and delete it. Now you can see these can get a little bit funny with the text, but if you just jostle with them, they will move to where you want them. So just move them around a bit and they will eventually click into place. It just wants to jump, that's fine. Okay, let's zoom out. And then let's create another space. Go to layout, merge cells. And then we've got another question here. So again, merge. Let's go back and develop that one. So again, we've got an overall rating here. So if you want an overall rating for the service you're providing or whatever you want feedback on, you can choose this question here and give a rating of 1 to 5. So let's paste that in. And here, just place in the numbers from 1 to 5 using your arrow key. Let's center those, select them all, go to layout, center align. And then once again, let's merge these cells for a space. And then we've got some text to go in at the bottom here. So let's just copy and paste that. There we go. Let's merge these cells here and then paste it in. And then you can use these for notes at the bottom if you want to, these additional cells, but I'm actually going to delete them. So select them, right click, go down to delete cells, and then check shift cells left and click OK, and they'll disappear. Now we can move this down a little bit, give us a little bit more space, and then we can look at the border lines. So select the table, go to table design, go to borders, click on the drop down and select no borders. Go to borders again and make sure you switch on the grid lines. So these grid lines are literally just a guide. They will not be printed out or saved if you save it as a PDF. They would just be there for guidance. So what I've just realized is we've forgotten to put the names in. Let's just introduce some more cells. So go to layout and go to insert cells below. So we need those 3 cells were actually there for a purpose. Select these 2 rows, go to split cells, and then simply go to 4 columns and click OK. Then move this line over so we can put name and phone in there. Move this line over so we can put email in there. So here we'll just type name. Here we'll type in phone number or phone, and then here we'll just put email. Now you don't have to do this. I understand it's a feedback form, so you don't have to do this. It's completely up to you, but I'll just show you how to do it if you want to. So now we need to put in all of those border lines. So I want to put in a line just here and here and then along here. So let's select this cell, go to table design, go to borders, click on the drop down, and we want a bottom border from where our cursor is. So select bottom border. Now a line has appeared here. I'll come back and show you how to get rid of that. Again, select that one and just click. You've already selected bottom border, you can see here. So just click, and the same here. So now we've got this line in between. So you can do a number of different things here. We've just got to get rid of it. So select those 2 cells, go to borders, and here you can see that inside horizontal border select it. So deselect that one, do the same over here, and select inside border. You can do it so that if you click on this cell, you can get rid of a top border, that might work. Click in here, get rid of the bottom border, that might work. It's just a case of trial and error. So this whole table, I want my cells to have borders. So select it all, go to borders and select all borders. Here, I would like all borders around there. So click and do the same. And again, there. So you can see we've now got all of those borders. So if I now just click within the table and take the grid lines off, that is exactly how your form will look. Now this email here, I want to move over and down a bit, and these 2 I just want to move down. So I'm going to select these 2, go to layout, and move them down to the bottom, but keep them to the left. The email, however, I want to put at the bottom right. If you want to put some information at the very bottom of this form, just to give it a detail or a number, you can double click at the bottom and go into the footers, put in your information, and if you're happy with it there, that's fine. But if you want to move it over to the left slightly, as some of these forms do, then select it, go up to the rulers. If you can't see rulers, go to view and check ruler. This top triangle here, just click and move that over and it will move that text over. Once you're happy, just double click back inside the main area of your document. And then to put a title in, you can just click at the top here, go to the center, put a title in and enlarge it, but I guarantee it's going to knock all of this down and you'll have a second page. So I'll teach you a technique that you can just utilize the space at the top and you don't have to worry about the default settings that Word comes with when entering text. Go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box, click and drag out a text box, type in your title, and then I'm going to select it, go to the Home tab, increase the font size by using this icon here, underline it and center it. If I deselect it, you can see we've got a borderline. So I'm going to get rid of that by selecting it, go to Shape Format, go to Outline and select No Outline. Once I'm happy, I'm going to make sure it's centered, go back to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center. Perfect. If it's too far to the top, just use your arrow key to move it down. Once you're happy with your form, you can then export it or you can save it. You can save it as a Word document, a PDF or a template. So go to File, go to Save As, and here under File Format, click on the drop down, you can go to PDF, or go to File, Save as Template. Make sure you're saving it to templates and make sure the file format is Microsoft Word template. If you do this, you can use this document over and over again and change it, make customizations to it. The original document will be saved in your templates and won't be affected. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.